a social worker's job. What do you think of this? What is your job as social workers?
Part-time job.
Huh? It's a part-time job for social workers. Like your job. Huh? We discussed something about the king's bakery. I'll talk to you. You must be having a lot of vouchers you should give us.
Yes.
Anyway, huh? What is our job, main job as social workers? Is it our main job is policy making? Our main job is policy analysis? Or our main job is policy implementation? Or our main job is policy monitoring? What is that? What is our main job?
Policy implementation.
Huh? Huh? All. Depends on the situation.
Yeah.
What is our main job?
We try to analyze all
this thing,
right?
Then
what does this
political science do? We'll do. If we do all this, right? What is our main job? Remember, I'm trying to link this to social work because we are social workers. And social policy is one class. And to me, social work and social policy is two sides of the same coin anyway. That's why I'm very much interested in this. Till now I never taught this course, but now I'm realizing social work is all about nothing but a policy-based profession. That means this policy is very important for us. So policy analysis, policy implementation, policy making, what is our main job then? Someone said all, you said all. That means for her, whatever she does, it is policy. But what is our main job? Policy evaluation? Or policy analysis, or policy making, policy monitoring,
policy users,
okay, or reaching policy to the people, or helping people to access policies. Is that make sense? We just do that. We don't worry about all this. Maybe, I don't know. There are all kinds of social workers again. There are certain social workers, you can see that they're interested in mindfulness. They're not interested in policy evaluation. But there are social workers who are interested in macro social work. For them, I think this is the thing. So some of you will become, I'm sure, macro social workers. And for them, it is important. For others also, it is important, at least, to understand what their colleagues are doing. Otherwise, you think you are doing the greatest work and your colleague is doing, you know, nonsense. That is, again, you know, at odds with your responsibilities with your colleagues. So though you are a micro social worker, a case worker, whatever, you should appreciate, recognize what your colleagues are doing in macro social work. For example, if they're talking about policy evaluation or policy analysis or policy implementation, or even policy making. There are, I think, 64 social workers or something like that, more than 50 in Obama's administration now. What are they doing? Working for Obama, what are they doing? They're involved in policy analysis, they're involved in policy evaluation, they're advising Obama on that, basically they're part of all this. The whole policy is what? Policy making, policy implementation, policy evaluation and monitoring, whatever, again policy making. Those are the 3-4 steps, right? Policy making, evaluation, and come back again, you know, improvise things. So all social workers are involved in all these things. So till now we understood what is policy making, who does what, how do we analyze. Now I think it's very important, policy evaluation. So can you say something about that? How do we evaluate? I say she's good, very hardworking, very careful, you know, intensive, you know, observer. But I'm saying that what I'm doing, I'm already making an evaluation and then saying on what basis I made this evaluation, maybe, you know, her behavior in last 4 classes, her participation, whatever. My own understanding about student behavior. What else? When we say that we want to evaluate, what are we doing? Looking at strengths and limitations. What else?
Achievements.
Yes. Evaluation.
Evaluating outcome and output.
Input, output, outcome, no, whatever, okay. Okay, outcome, output. What is outcome and what is output? Again, we'll discuss maybe. A little confusion there. But yeah, we are looking at that. When we are saying evaluation, we are getting there. Okay, what else? There is internal evaluation, there is external evaluation, there is midterm evaluation, there is final evaluation, there is ex post evaluation, there is ex ante, you know. So how do we understand this evaluation then? Have you done any evaluation studies till now? Or been part of, maybe you're part of some evaluation studies? You will be evaluating me at the end of this course. What does that mean? There will be a form given to you and you will tick all these things and someone will analyze and they'll give me, you know, the results back. Last time, I'm in the 10th position in the teacher's evaluation. Maybe this time, number one, boom, about 28. There are indicators. There are indicators on which basis I'm being evaluated. My whatever delivery, content, there are a lot of things. So what is policy evaluation then? When we want to evaluate education policy, what is that we should look into? Outcomes, outputs, achievements, results, what else? Benefits, okay. Delivery, okay, how is it being delivered, okay. What else? Cost effectiveness, okay, how effective is that? Okay, you spent 20 hours in the operation theater and the patient died. 20 hours, a lot of investment, and then patient died. You're making an evaluation. Why it happened? How it happened? What else? So when we are evaluating, what are we evaluating? Effectiveness? Effectiveness, efficiency, economics. What else? Come on here. Evidence. Okay. You said what? Evidence? You said something else.
I ask you to give the hints.
You give the hints, okay. No, when we say evaluation, what we mean by that? You'll start from there and we'll see the slides later.
We see a result.
You see results.
And then we start to see whether you have met the objective.
Okay. On what basis we evaluate? When we are evaluating, we are taking some base, right? We just can't evaluate just like that. So we are taking certain base, certain indicators.
Yeah.
Against which we evaluate whether this person is good, bad, outstanding, excellent, whatever. You know? My daughter asks, what is the difference between good and excellent?
Okay.
Sometimes I write excellent, sometimes I write good, sometimes I write very good.
Uh-huh.
What is that? How do you explain it?
Very
good and excellent.
Very
good. Huh? Very good. Slowly spelling. Very good is very good. Huh? Anyway, there are a lot of books on this. If you really want to become a policy evaluator, a lot of books on this. People are also saying that it's evidence-based policy making, evidence-based social work, evidence-based counseling, whatever. What is this evidence-based? We will not go there, but I take this slide from the World Bank website. This is what they're saying when it comes to policy evaluation. If you are in a World Bank, ADB or JKM or whatever, you'll be doing this job, evaluating policies. How do you evaluate? These are the four steps. You look at the planning, you look at the budgeting, you look at monitoring procedures, and you evaluate. And when you evaluate, there are executive evaluations, there are indicators evaluations, there are process evaluations, and there are impact evaluation. There are different types of evaluation. There are so many. This is just one way to look at evaluations. So basically this slide tells us evaluation is an important part of planning, implementation, budgeting, monitoring and evaluation. After evaluation you again feedback whatever to make the planning better. So when we are saying evaluating policy, what we are doing is most basic form of evaluation of policy is to ask whether it meets its objectives. That's what I think Rodhir said. Just ask the question, you are getting into the whole spectrum of evaluation. Why is that this policy made that particular choice? You just ask that, you're getting into choice analysis. When we want to evaluate whether this policy has met its stated objectives. So you have a time period, 2012, this is what's said. In 2035, whether the education blueprint has achieved all the shifts that it mentioned in 2012. If yes, how much? If they have not achieved these goals, why is that they have not achieved these goals? What should have been done? What went wrong? So if you're asking that one simple question, whether it met its objectives. So when you're asking this question, it seems you're asking about the very effectiveness of the policy. Effectiveness and efficiency. How do we understand? Again, I'm coming to that. Effectiveness and efficient. He's an efficient teacher. He's an effective teacher. What do we say?
Efficiency is the process.
Effectiveness, the result. The very efficient doctor. The effectiveness is that the patient survived. He is a very efficient driver. That's why he won the Malaysia one race formula or whatever. So efficiency and effectiveness. So if we are asking these things, we're actually getting into evaluation. So if you ask whether this policy meets its objectives or not, you're asking already whether it is effectiveness. A policy is effective if it meets its aims, otherwise it's not effective. When you are saying effectiveness, whether it is cost effective or not, that's another issue that you can look into this. So there is another here. I think this will tell you all the things that we were talking about policy evaluation. What do you think about this? Policy is formulated, again it's evaluated. If it is unsuitable, again, you know. If it is suitable, then it at least go to the second phase. It's being implemented. Again it's being evaluated. Then again the results will go back. Again, maybe a new policy come or mid-course policy correction will take place. Otherwise, it will continue to policy implementation. If it is a success, the continuation will take place. If it is unsuccessful, maybe again it will take place. When you look into that, maybe this could be one criteria on which basis you can suggest whether it is successful or unsuccessful. The criteria here is effectiveness, efficiency, flexibility, equity. We are not talking equality here. Institutional constraints and community acceptance. These are some of the points that in this slide which I have taken from UNESCO, UNSCAP, the United Nations. What is SCAP? Economic services? Something like that. And anyway, also we will see that. Maybe you guys look into this. This is what they use when it comes to evaluation. What do you think about this evaluation criteria? Effectiveness, okay, we can understand that. Efficiency, yes. Flexibility, how flexible is this policy? Also, you know, part of evaluation. Equity, whether resources are distributed according to the needs and aspirations. Not equally, but equitably. When you're asking equitably, you're asking an evaluating question. Yes, everyone got two shoes. Everyone get 200 ringgits. But maybe someone needs 300 ringgits, someone only needs 100 ringgits. Equitable. Whether this particular policy is equitable or not, then you're getting into evaluating it. Institutional constraints. What are the institutional constraints and how this particular policy is being able to manage or not able to manage, and community acceptance. So these are some of the indicators or criteria that we can use to evaluate a policy. I can go on to this. Any questions?
Can you please elaborate more on the flexibility?
I will. But what do you think these indicators? We can add more indicators. But maybe we'll first focus on these and then we can add more. Okay? Flexibility. Suitability of policy measures may also be judged by the extent to which they can be adapted to changing market, technology, knowledge, social, political, and environmental conditions. What do you mean by that? Look at our education policy. Is it flexible or is it very rigid? Is it able to meet the changing, you know, market needs? Is it reflecting the students' aspirations? Is it responding to the knowledge levels that we are supposed to create or knowledge levels that we want to achieve? Or it says, no, this is what we want to achieve and that's it. No corrections. It's very rigid. So if it is very rigid or it's very flexible, you know, how many points that you give, for example. So you want to evaluate a policy and you see the structure. How rigid or how flexible is that? So when you're saying flexibility, maybe you can see these things. Okay, this policy is very flexible when it comes to market needs, but it's very rigid when it comes to student choices. So by saying that, what do you mean? So this policy is flexible only to market needs. That means anytime the fees can be increased or decreased or whatever. But it's very rigid on student choices, for example. So by saying that, you are already saying a very important thing. You're evaluating policy against. It's very flexible on one account, but very rigid on many aspects. So in total, I consider this policy is very rigid and not many corrections can be done. Is that useful? Flexibility. Looking at flexibility to evaluate a policy.
Innovations or whatever, so it's been able to meet its objectives.
No, our education system is not able to meet its objectives because it is effective, it is efficient, but it's not flexible. The community is not accepting it. See? So basically, when you are saying evaluation, you have a criteria. And each criteria can be divided into certain indicators. So you are assessing the objectives against your criteria and your indicators. Does that make some little complex? Evaluation. I'm sure some of you will become evaluators. Because evaluation is a very important thing. A lot of money, a lot of work is going on. Because all NGOs are being evaluated, right? I'm being evaluated, you are being evaluated, NGOs are being evaluated. Evaluation is a very important skill for social workers again. What are you doing with your clients? You are actually evaluating the strengths and limitations on which you are making decisions. Evaluation. Shall we do it next class? Too much? I just introduced evaluation today, right? If you know, I'm not going to rush you. We'll again do it in next class. On these five things, maybe we'll add more. So, how to do an evaluation? And what to do in evaluation? Okay? So, can someone say what is it we will learn today? Maybe I'll call the name otherwise. Yeah, we have 5 minutes, yeah. What is that we have done? Tell me, what is that you have learned today? What is that you like today? Write it, give it to me. Okay. Take a piece of paper, please. Small piece of paper. And write, don't write your name. Write what is that you have learned today. Two things that you have learned today. Two things that you have understood, learned, and appreciated, liked, whatever. And two things that you didn't like or you didn't understand. Because I will focus on that next class. You are not writing your name, I don't know your writing, so there is no evaluation on that. Okay? So it will not affect your teacher-student relationships. You are just giving me your feedback. And there is a difference between feedback and evaluation. So two things that you like, okay? Or you have learned, you have understood, or you appreciate, whatever. Two things that plus, two things minus, which I will improve on. Okay?